The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 20 through 24, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 10th, 1966, in New York.
We have been discussing this sloka since the last 2 days in our meetings. The next verse is Tatta Padmaphalasannam Nitya Tripta Nirashraya Karmani Abhipravittovi Naiva Kinchit Karoti. In order to be free from the reaction of our work, this formula is prescribed by Sri Krishna. Yadrichhalavasantushta dandatita vimatsara sama siddhavasiddhosa krityapina lulandhati. Gata sangasya muttasya jainavastuta ketasaha jaggayata charata karma samagram kabiliya. The formula is that we have to be detached from the result of the work and must be situated in full knowledge, in full knowledge. Unless we are situated in full knowledge, it is not possible to be detached from the work which we are doing. And that detachment and that knowledge, to be situated in full knowledge, is possible when we perform yajna or sacrifice. Now today's subject matter is varieties of sacrifice. How we can perform different kinds of sacrifice. And what is the sacrifice? Sacrifice means yajñārtha karma. Just at the present moment, our conception is that I am the proprietor of everything. Actually, I am not the proprietor. The Isha Upanishad says that Isha-vāsanidam tadvam, the Supreme Lord, Personality of Godhead, or Krishna, He is the proprietor. But by deluded by the illusory energy of a material existence, we are thinking that I am the proprietor. Therefore, in the scripture, in Vedic scripture, the sacrifice is recommended. Sacrifice means you give voluntarily. You give voluntarily because we have been so much attached to this material proprietorship. That, and without that attachment, there is no possibility of our becoming free from this material entanglement. But that attachment is very difficult to give up. Therefore, sacrifice has been recommended, that you sacrifice. It is, supposing that it is your proprietorship, you are the proprietor of everything. But you sacrifice yajñārtha. Yajñārtha means for the Supreme Lord. So many sacrifices are recommended in various scriptures. So we shall try to discuss some of the sacrifices. Yajñāya charata karma samagram pravidhyate. If we perform our duties, yajna, for the matter of satisfaction of Vishnu, the Supreme Lord, then we shall not be bound up by the reaction of any war. Now, the first thing is, in the sacrifice, according to the Vedic rites, there are five principal factors. What are those? There is sacrifice on fire, altar. And the person who is offering the, generally in the sacrifice, grains and butter, clarified butter is offered. So the sacrifice of altar, fire, and the offering ingredients, grains and clarified butter, and the person who is offering sacrifice, three, and the result and the performance. These five things are there in the matter of sacrifice. Now Krishna says to eat these five things are transformed into Krishna consciousness or Brahma realization. Then the result will be that the man who is performing that sacrifice is sure to attain his spiritual salvation and go back to Godhead. This prescription is recommended in the Bhagavad Gita. That brahmarpanam brahma havi brahmagno brahmana hutam brahmahiva tena gantavyam brahma karma samadhana. Now, brahmarpanam, sacrifice for whom? For the Brahma. And Krishna is the supreme Brahma. Therefore, sacrifice for Krishna is brahmarpanam, and sacrificing for the Brahma, Supreme Brahma. Because Krishna is described in the 10th chapter as the Param Brahma, the Supreme Brahma. Brahma means we are also all Brahma. Because we are all fragmental parts and parcels of the Supreme Being, Krishna. Therefore, we are also Brahma. Just like particles of gold is also gold. Similarly, we are fragmental portions of Krishna. Do not understand that as material fragments. We are not material fragments. But so, just because we have no other conception at the present moment, except material understanding. Therefore, I am just trying, or this is translated into English as fragment, but not like the material fragments. Just like we have got a paper in our hand. If I tear into pieces, they become fragments. Then the original paper, the shape of the paper, no longer existing. It is not like that. The Upanishad says that Purnamidam, Purnamadha, Purna Purnam Lakshyate, Purnasya Purnamadaya, Purnamevava Vishishyate. The spiritual conception is that any number of fragments of the whole can be taken from the whole spirit. It is still the spirit whole is as it is. That is the description in the Vedic literature. We have got material idea, 1 minus 1 equal to 0. But But in the spiritual realm, 1 minus 1 equals 1. So these fragments, the fragments of the Supreme Brahma, Krishna, we are. So with that consciousness, we have to sacrifice. Brahmakanam, Brahmahavi. And the thing which you are sacrificing, you have to understand that the things belong to the Supreme Brahma. Brahmakanam, Brahmahavi, Brahmagno. And the fire which is on the altar, that is to be understood as the energy of the Supreme Brahma. And Brahmanahutam, and the person who is offering the sacrifice, he is also part and parcel of the Supreme Brahma. In this way, if we offer sacrifice, then Brahma, Brahmaiva tena gantarva. The person who is offering such sacrifice is sure to attain spiritual salvation. This is Brahma Parma Samadhina. And the performance is just according to the Vedic injunction. So in this way, if we, execute the duties of our living condition, then the result will be that at the end we shall be attaining as a Brahma. And the whole process is called Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness. In the higher conception of life, just it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita that everything is visualized as Brahma. Brahma means spiritual. So in the higher conception of life, one who has attained in the higher stage of spiritual realization, for him there is nothing material. There is nothing material. The distinction of matter and spirit is this. Now, from the Bhagavad Gita, we understand that two energies are working. One energy is called inferior energy and the other energy is called superior energy. Now take for example the inferior energy. The energy emanating from the source, is there any possibility of dividing the energy and the energetic? No, that is not possible. Just like you cannot divide heat from the fire or the illumination from this light. This is not possible. If there is no illumination, then the light has no meaning. If there is no heat, then fire has no meaning. Similarly, if the energy is separated from the energetic, the energy has no meaning. So Krishna says that there are two kinds of nature. Superior nature or higher nature and inferior nature. Now in the inferior nature, we take it for granted that there is something like inferior nature. Of course this material energy, material nature is called inferior nature. Inferior in the sense that the matter has got no incentive. Without touch of spirit, matter cannot work. Therefore, it is understood that it is inferior. But in the higher sense, it is not inferior. How it is not inferior? Because it is emanation from the Supreme, and you cannot separate this energy from the Supreme, and there is no difference between the Supreme and its energy. Sakti, Saktimato, Abheda. This is the Vedic injunction. Sakti, Sakti means energy. And Sakti Mata means the person who has got the energy. So, Abheda, they are non-differential. It cannot be differentiated between the energy and the energetic. Just like electric powerhouse, the energy is electricity. Now, from the electricity, energy, we are working so many things. So far our household affairs are concerned, by the same electric energy, we are getting heat and we are getting also cold. And the refrigerator, you see, everything is cold. In the heater, we find everything is hot, warm. But the same energy is working. So one who knows that this is the electrical energy that is working in a different way, for him there is no superior or inferior. That is called gap. If we are on the platform of knowledge, then there is no distinction between matter and spirit. And that knowledge we have to acquire. How we have to acquire? We must know it definitely, that everything that is manifested. Vishnu Purana, there is a nice verse which describes this energy and the energetic very nicely. Eko desa sthita sarne jyoshna vistar na jatha parasya brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. Akhilam jagat. Whatever we are seeing in this, in our presence, whatever we are seeing, they are nothing but different energies of the Supreme Lord. And how they are acting, just like the electric powerhouse is situated far away from your residential apartment, but from there the energy is being distributed and you are finding heat, cold, and so many things electrically you are watching. So although the Supreme Lord is far, far away, of course he is not far, far away, but in our conception, in the material conception, because we cannot see, we are on a different planet, and so by his energy he is not far away. Just like the sunlight, the sunshine, in the morning you find the sunshine is within your room. But sun is just within your room. It is actually, but it's still, the sun is 90 million miles away from you. Similarly, in all circumstances, we must understand that Krishna is, although far away from us, is still, he is with us, within us. This is called knowledge. This is called knowledge. And he says also in the Bhagavad Gita that sarvatsacaham ridhisannivishta. I am situated in everyone's heart. So just think how much nearest he is. He is sitting at my heart and he is actually there. It is called Paramatma, the Super Soul. So sarvasya, sarvasya means everyone, not only in human body, but in animal body, in the atoms also. Andantarastham paramanusayantarastham. Paramanu means the atom. He is situated. So practically he is not far away. He is the nearest friend. He also claims in the Bhagavad Gita, Sridam Sarva Bhutanam, I am the friend of everyone. So this knowledge we have to acquire, that we have got the greatest powerful friend in Krishna, and he is with me. This is knowledge. Just like when you chant Krishna, Hare Krishna, actually the fact is, Krishna is dancing on your tongue by sound vibration. Krishna is not aware. It is stated in the scripture, Naham Tishthami Vaikunthe. He is addressing Narada. Narada, a great devotee of Krishna. He is explaining to Narada, Naham Tishthami Vaikunthe Yoginam Hridaye Sucha. The yogi, the mystic yogi, they try to find out the super soul within themselves. That is the yoga system. Yoga, actual yoga system is to concentrate the mind, to focus the mind on the super soul. That is yoga system. So Krishna says that Naham Tishthami Vaikunthe. In the scriptures we find that kingdom of God, that is called Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means yugadha kuntha jatra. Kuntha means anxiety. The place where there is no anxiety, that is called Vaikuntha. So Krishna says, the naham tishthami vaikunthe yoginam hridayeshu cha. My dear Narada, do not think that I am staying in the Vaikuntha, in the kingdom of God only, or in the heart of the yogis only. No. Tattva tishthami Narada jatra bhayanti madhvatya. Wherever my devotees sing or chant the glories of me, I stand there, I go there. So this is Brahmarpanam, this jagda, this is the highest jagda. Now we are discussing of the varieties of jagda. Now so far, sacrifice in the altar of fire, clarified butter and grains, it is not possible. At the present moment, of course, formally, we understand from the scriptures that they used to pour tons of tons clarified butter in the fire. Because at that time, they were animals. But at the present moment, of course, we are seeing some butter sticks here in America, but from India, practically, butter has disappeared. So, it is not possible. The present day Kali Yuga is not favorable for such sacrifice which was being performed in the Satya Yuga or Treta, not Satya Yuga, sacrifice was being performed in the Treta Yuga, second millennium. The duration of a period, just like in a year, we have got different seasons. Similarly, in the existence, there are different periods according to Vedic literature. They are called Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapar Yuga, Kali Yuga. Now we are passing through the Kali Yuga. The Kali Yuga, the duration of Kali Yuga is 400 thousands of years. 427,000 of years. Out of that, we have passed only 5,000 of years. That is the Vedic calculation. The Lord Chaitanya has recommended this jagda. It is not Lord Chaitanya's imagination. It is recommended in the Bhagavad that Kiteja Dhyato Vishnu Tretayam Jajato Makhai Dapare Paritat Jayam Salotad Harikitana. Now these four yugas are divided. Krita means in Satyajur. When people were all virtuous, that is called Satyajur. So, Krita Tad Dhyato Vishnu, in the Satyajuga, what was attained by meditation on Vishnu, we shall always remember that whenever we call for meditation, that meditation is not in void. Void meditation is very much troublesome. Kesa avigataraste sam padvakta sakta ketasa, you'll find in the Bhagavad Gita. Those who are trying to meditate upon the void, they are in very troublesome condition. And it is very difficult to achieve success. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. So meditation always means meditation on Vishnu. So in the Satya Yuga, in the millennium, when all people were virtuous, 10% virtuous, at that time this meditation was recommended. That was the process recommended. Kriteja Dhyato Vishnu Tretayam Jagato Makhai. Tretayam means the next millennium. That is, it was recommended that people should perform sacrifice. Tretayam Jagato Makhai Dapare Parishajaya. Dapare means the next millennium. That is recommended for temple worship. Temple worship. The temple worship, the so many temples, thousands and thousands of temples you will find, not only in India, in other parts of the world also. The churches are also temples, the mosques are also temples, the synagogues are also temples. So, this temple worship was introduced in the third millennium. Now, this is the fourth millennium. In the fourth millennium, the Bhagavad says that Salotan Harikitana, this is yoga. Other yogas, although they are prescribed, because when Krishna was speaking, he was speaking generally, but there are specific considerations. This yoga recommended in the Bhagavad Gita, Brahmatmanam Brahma, Brahma Havi Brahmagno Brahmanahuta. Where is the fire? And where is the clarified butter? And where is the expert performer of yoga? The performer of yoga must be so much educated. There was a talk between Lord Chaitanya and a Mohammedan magistrate. Because when Lord Chaitanya appeared in Bengal, India was being governed by the Mohammedan Spartans in the 15th century, 500 years before. And Lord Chaitanya appeared about 480 years before. So there was a talk between Lord Chaitanya and the Mohammedan magistrate. Now, just like also learn that we are performing this kirtan, some tenants in this house, he has taken objection. And just to avoid misunderstanding, so I am closing this door. But it is becoming very too much discomfited. I can see people are not feeling comfortable. Anyway, apart from that, now this misunderstanding of kirtan, 500 years before also there was, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was performing kirtan, the not the Mohammedans, but the Hindus, they took objection that this is not according to our scripture. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has introduced something new, so he complained to the magistrate. Although the magistrate was Mohammedan, his government representative, so he took action. What action was taken? That first of all he wore the Lord Chaitanya's party, that he cannot perform Sankirtan. Then Lord Chaitanya's party neglected. Then the magistrate sent some constables and he broke the mridanga. You have seen the mridanga. So there was some disturbance. And Lord Chaitanya formed a party of 100,000 people from Navadvip, and he began to make a civil disobedience. He performed Sankirtan all over the city, and there was some trouble between the Mohammedan magistrate. And at last they came to compromise. And when the compromise was done, then there was some discussion. The discussion was the distinction between Mohammedan religion and Hindu religion. Now, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first of all inquired the Mohammedan magistrate that they established their relation as the uncle and nephew. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became the nephew and the Qazi, the magistrate, he became the uncle. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu addressed the uncle, my dear uncle, why you are killing your father and mother? The uncle replied, what is that, killing our father and mother? I said, yes, because if the cow is your mother, she gives milk, and the bull, he helps you in the agricultural field, she produces grain. So just like father and mother, mother supplies milk and father brings grain. So they are your father and mother. How you are killing your father and mother? So the uncle replied that he was also very educated, learned. He said that in your Vedic scripture there is cow sacrifice. So you are also killing cow. That I am going to explain the sacrifice. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained there that that was not killing. When there was some animal sacrifice, an old animal would be sacrificed in the altar, but it would be given a new life. It was practically testing of the Vedic mantra by the qualified Brahmin. So he said, because at the present moment there are no qualified Brahmin, therefore such kind of sacrifice is stopped. That was his explanation. So these sacrifices means, unless they are performed very nicely according to the rules and regulations as they are mentioned in scripture, they will not produce the desired result. That is the way of sacrifice. Now, here it is said, brahmāpanam brahmahavi. Now, where is the butter? Where is the grain? And where is the qualified Brahmin who can chant the mantra, hymns very nicely so that he can get the result? So any kind of sacrifice at the present age is impossible. It's not possible. The only sacrifice that kirtan, sankirtan, yajna, that is possible, which we have just now said. This was introduced and this is recommended in Bhagavad. This is authoritative. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the incarnation of Krishna, that is confirmed in Mahabharata, Bhagavad, Puran, Upanishad. Now in the Bhagavad, in the 11th canto, we find the symptoms of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in which it is stated that jagvai saṅkirtanai prāyai jajanti hi sumenata. Those who are intelligent persons in this age, in Kali Yuga, they will perform Sankirtan Jagda and satisfied Lord Krishna, Chaitanya. So this Sankirtan Jagda, that which was performed, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So, if we think, if we are Krishna conscious, that I am eternal fragments of Krishna, therefore, my duty is, that everyone can understand what is the duty of the fragment to the whole. Fragment to the whole. That Krishna is the whole. Whole machine, suppose. This mechanical work we can understand. The whole machine is there. But there is a small screw which is fragment of that machine. So that screw should be properly adjusted in the machine and it will help the machine working nicely. Similarly, we are all different fragments of the Supreme Krishna. And if we dovetail ourselves in the work of Krishna, that is the highest jagda, that is the performance of jagda. We haven't got to search out for large quantity of butter, clarified butter or drink. That is impossible factor now. It is very difficult to secure butter for eating purposes, and who is going to sacrifice? That is not possible. Although that is mentioned in the different scriptures, the sacrifice should be performed in that way, but it is impractical. It is not possible. So such sacrifices as recommended in the scriptures by offering clarified butters and grains or sacrificing some animal, there are so many. Now this sacrifice of animals was protested by Lord Buddha. He deviated from the Hindu religion. Lord Buddha was born in Hindu family. He was Kshatriya. He was a king's son. But he wanted to preach non-violence. He wanted to preach completely, to stop completely animal killing. But because in the Vedic, of course, I have already explained that sacrifice of animals as stated in the Vedas, they are not for killing. They are meant for giving a new life to the animal. By Vedic mantra, the Vedic mantra is so powerful that was a test how a dead animal can get a new one. An old animal is sacrificed and it gets a new usefulness. That was the test. It was not meant for killing. Don't misunderstand that sacrifice, but that is mentioned in the Veda. So people misused the sacrifice name, the sacrifice they wanted to give evidence from Veda. So every animal sacrifice is mentioned in the Veda. Why we shall stop? So Lord Buddha started this movement, completely stopping this animal sacrifice, but he knew that these foolish men will come and give me evidence that here in the Vedas animal sacrifice is recommended. Why you are preaching? Why you are preaching stoppage of animal killing? Therefore, he completely rejected this. He said that I don't accept this. That is stated in a very nice verse about Lord Buddha by a Vaishnava poet. Ninnasi jagda vidhe rahaha suti jatam sadaya ridaya dar sitapasu ghatam kesa madhita buddha sarira jaya jagadisa hare. It's very nice to compose. The idea is that the poet is praying Lord Buddha. Lord Buddha is also mentioned in Bhagavata as incarnation of Krishna. So, he is praying, Lord Buddha, my dear Lord, you have achieved now the Buddha, sari, body, just by taking compassion on the poor animals. And therefore, you are also duplicating the animal sacrifices recommended in the Vedas. So because Lord Buddha did not accept, he had to do that, because his mission was to stop animal sacrifice and animal killing. Now the foolish person, without knowing the Vedic patras, the present, here is recommended in the Vedas, then there will be disturbance. So he had to discharge, he had to go out of the Vedic rules and regulations, and he preached his own philosophy. Hmm. So, therefore, sacrifice, any kind of sacrifice, that sacrifice is now consolidated in the sacrifice of I'm sacrificing your time and sitting down here and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. This is the best kind of sacrifice recommended by Lord Chaitanya for this age. He says that Karo Naseva 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 Dasiranyatha Harinnama 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 Iva Kevalam. Just like if we want to give space on a particular subject matter, we say that do this, do this, do this. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya also stressed on this performance of Sankirtan and cries. He says, Kalo Nasteva, 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 Gatiramnatha. In this age of Kali, there is no other way. There is no other way. There is no other way. Christ is and what is that? Haran Nama, Haran Nama, Haran Nama, your favor. Now here also Christ. Simply just chant Krishna's name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. So this is the best kind of sacrifice. That's because other sacrifices, they are also recognized. Just like yoga. Yoga is also recognized. But that was meant for in the Satya Yuga, when all people were very much, all virtual, 10% virtual. There is no, sinful man at all. Now as the age advanced in the Treta Yuga, there were 75% virtual and 25% sinful. In the Dwapar Yuga, 50% virtual and 50% sinful. And in this age, Kali Yuga, almost 10% sinful. Although it is calculated in the Shastra that 75% are sinful and 25% are. And that you can see how many percentages are going to join our this Sankirtan movement, you can see from the audience. So it is difficult, but it is the fact. If we perform this sacrifice nicely, according to the rules recommended by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are sure to get salvation. Nishtitam. Nishtitam means sure. Let us perform this sacrifice with patience and perseverance, with steadiness, and then surely we shall achieve the desired result, spiritual salvation, which is that it is stated, the brahmaiva tena gantavyam. The whole thing is meant for go back to home, go back to Godhead. That is the whole thing. This is not our home, neither it is our place. We come here as a foreigner, just like I have come to your place as a foreigner. Suppose I am here for last 1 year, I may remain here for 3 months more or 1 year more, or then I may go back. Similarly, we are all foreigners in this material world. We come here for sacrifice. That is change, changing body, changing place. So this is not our place. Our real place is back to Godhead, back to home. So if we want to go to our home, back, and live there permanently in eternal life, in blissfulness and complete knowledge, then this Krishna consciousness should be adopted very seriously. It should be preached to the human society so that they can also take advantage of this nice program thanks. That is the highest service you can offer to the human society. This sacrifice of Sankirtan Yoga. It is nothing manufactured. It is recommended in Vedic literature. It was actually performed by Lord Chaitanya. So there is nothing unauthorized. It is completely authorized. So I shall request all friends and audience here to take up the matter very seriously and just try to execute it, although there are some impediments. So any good thing you do, there will be so many impediments.